At this point in the lecture series, we've covered the main important topics for analysis with public transit data. Here, I want to talk about some additional tools we have for creating and editing GTFS data, in case that's something you're interested in. We do not have a full experience for creating GTFS data, unfortunately. So if you're looking to create a GTFS dataset from scratch, Esri products really aren't the right tool for that job. But we do have a couple of tools to help you create or edit the geographic components of a GTFS dataset: the stops and the shapes. In this video, I'll show you how you can edit your GTFS stops using the GTFS stops to features and features to GTFS stops tools. Then I'll show you how you can create a shapes.txt file for your GTFS dataset if you don't have one. If you want to make some edits in your GTFS stops.txt file, you can use the following workflow. First, run the GTFS stops to features tool and create a feature class from your GTFS stops. Then, make any edits you need to in the map and using the attribute table. And then finally, run the Features to GTFS Stops tool to create a new version of your stops.txt file that includes the updates. Actually, you could even create a GTFS stops.txt file from scratch if you wanted to. You would just create a point feature class with all the necessary fields, create the features using the editing tools, and update the fields in the attribute table, and then you could just export it to GTFS using Features to GTFS Stops. The optional GTFS shapes.txt file contains a representation of the geographic paths taken by transit vehicles in a transit system. A good GTFS shapes.txt file is important for GTFS-based routing apps to display transit routes correctly on the map. Although many transit agencies generate their shapes.txt files using GPS trackers on their vehicles, other transit agencies lacking this hardware may have trouble creating this file. We have some tools designed to help you generate a shapes.txt file for your agency if you fall into this latter category. The Generate Shapes Features from GTFS and Features to GTFS Shapes tools allow you to create a new shapes.txt file based on the stop, route, and schedule information from an existing GTFS dataset. The first tool uses the Network Analyst extension Route Solver to generate good estimates for the geographic paths used by vehicles in the transit system. You can get the estimated shapes as a feature class and edit it in the map. Then you can review and edit those line features before exporting them to a new shapes.txt file. So the workflow is as follows. First, run the Generate Shapes Features from GTFS tool to estimate the shapes based on Network Analyst. Second, make any edits you need to in the map. And then finally, run the Features to GTFS Shapes tool to generate a new shapes.txt file and update the associated GTFS files with shape ID and linear referencing information. To do this workflow, you'll need a Network Analyst extension and a network dataset suitable for modeling bus driving, or you can use the ArcGIS online services and you'll need sufficient credits for the analysis. You should not use a network dataset configured for modeling pedestrians traveling by public transit. Remember, right now you're modeling how buses drive through the road network, not how passengers ride on buses. Now I'll show you a demo of creating a new shapes.txt file using this workflow. Let's see how to create a new shapes.txt file for a GTFS dataset. For this exercise, let's focus on the area south of Cincinnati, south of the river. The dataset that comes with the tutorial data already has a shapes.txt file, but for the purpose of this exercise, let's just pretend it doesn't, or pretend like we need to create a new one for some reason. Let's search for the Generate Shapes Features from GTFS tool. So I need to tell the tool which GTFS dataset I want to work with, and I'll choose the tank dataset from the tutorial data. And then I need to designate an output feature class for the shape lines and an output feature class for the associated shape stops. And I also need to designate a text file for an output trips.txt file, because this file will be updated to be associated with the shape IDs that are generated when I run the tool. In this section, I can designate which GTFS modes of transit should be generated using the network for shapes as opposed to straight lines. Anything that's checked will use the network dataset to travel along the streets in the network to generate the shapes, and anything unchecked will generate shapes using straight lines connecting stops. It makes sense, for example, that we wouldn't want to generate shapes using the network for a subway because subways don't drive on streets. Now, this tank dataset, I think, doesn't have anything in it except buses, so most of this will be irrelevant, but that's okay. This section down at the bottom has network options. So I want to select a network dataset to use, and I'm going to use a StreetMap Premium dataset that I have that covers this area. And I created a special travel mode on that StreetMap Premium data for bus driving, so I'll select bus driving time. And this travel mode is configured with some options that are specifically useful for modeling buses driving through the network. Now, these other options are advanced options, and yes, my buses drive on the right side of the road, and I won't talk about bearing and bearing angle at this point. You can read the documentation if you want to learn more about those. I'll just leave them as defaults. And now I'll run the tool. Okay, the tool is finished. Note that it completed with warnings. Let's take a look. So the warning I get says that calculating shapes along the network failed for 2 out of 120 shape IDs. Straight line shape features will be generated for the affected shape IDs, and then it has a list of the shapes that were affected. So this is good to note because it means that for some reason, some of these shapes, just the route wasn't able to calculate something on the network. And so I might want to pay special attention to these two shape IDs when I'm reviewing the results in the map. And I might need to make some manual corrections. So let's take a look at the results in the map. You can see there's a bunch of lines here and a bunch of points. Essentially, the shapes are these line features. And these are estimated shapes. So this is based on the locations and sequences of stops that it found in the GTFS dataset. The tool has calculated a route along the streets to reach each of those stops in the correct order. And it's created this line feature class with the estimates of those shapes. This might not actually be the exact route that your bus travels. And so that's why you need to investigate each one of these shapes, make edits if necessary, and then save your changes before you export this to an actual shapes.txt file. The stops feature class is just for reference, and the stops are shown with their sequence order, so that it's easier for you to determine whether the route is correct and which stops are associated with which route. Let's see how we would investigate each individual route and make corrections if needed. I've zoomed into downtown here, and you can see that it's kind of a mess. All of the routes are overlapping, there's numbers everywhere, and really the best thing to do is to go through one by one, set up a definition query for each shape ID, and investigate that shape individually. Let's set up a definition query for shape ID 7. Okay, so we have now just one single shape going from downtown Cincinnati out to the suburbs, it looks like. So actually things look pretty good in general, but I noticed that there's something happening here at the end. And it looks like this is probably going into some sort of office or industrial park, and probably my network dataset just doesn't even have a street that goes out here, and so something happened and this stop wasn't reached or it snapped to some strange location. And you can see that the end is, it's making a little curve and stopping here at number 12. So we want to fix this shape. So I can use the editing tools to correct this. Let's start with edit vertices. Just select this and take this last vertex and we'll just extend it up this way. And then I can use the continue feature tool to continue drawing this line up this way until the shape reaches my last stop. Okay, and then I can clear that and save my edits. And then I could continue the process and go one by one through all 120 shapes. And yeah, that's going to be kind of an arduous process. Not sure what else to suggest, though. When you're finished editing, make sure you remove all your definition queries before you try to export these as a shapes.txt file, because otherwise it will only use the shapes that are currently active in the definition query. Okay, so assuming I've made all the changes I need to make to the shape geometry, I'm ready to export this as a shapes.txt file. So I'll open the Features to GTFS Shapes tool. And it needs my shapes and my stops for reference. It needs my updated trips.txt file that I created earlier. Again, for reference. It needs the stop times file from my GTFS dataset. And it wants an output location for the new shapes.txt file and the updated stoptimes.txt file. Now I'm just parking these in a temporary location in my project folder because I want to take a look at them and investigate them before I overwrite any of my existing GTFS data. It's also asking me for distance units, so these will be the units that are logged in the shape dist traveled fields in my shapes.txt file and my stoptimes.txt file. GTFS doesn't care what the units are, but you're welcome to choose any of these that work for you. And I'll run the tool. The tool is finished. Note that it completed with warnings. Let's take a look. So internally, this tool does some linear referencing in order to update the shape dist traveled field in stoptimes.txt. And what this warning message says is that for some shapes, the measured distance of stops along the shape line does not match the correct sequence of the stops. And this indicates a problem with the geometry of the shapes. The linear referencing does the best job it can with the data it has, but if there's something strange about the shape geometry and the stop sequence snaps to that line sort of out of order, sometimes the linear referencing can't find a way to correct it. And so this warning message tells you which shape IDs are affected, and these are ones that you probably need to go back and review in the geometry of your shapes, make sure that you edit them to be correct, and then rerun the Features to GTFS Shapes tool. And you should keep in mind that the shape dist traveled field values will probably be incorrect. If some application is using your shapes.txt file and your stoptimes.txt file to render shapes in the map for travelers, it might render them incorrectly because the stops are not at the correct locations along the line. So you just need to make sure to go back and check all these shape IDs and make sure that they're correct. In our case, it's not surprising that there's so many because I didn't really spend any time editing anything. I just made that one small edit that you saw me do as an example.